Yeah, first of all, thank you so much to Brooklyn Friends and to the committee for the Black History Celebration for inviting me. I think it's wonderful that you're showing this film, that you're exposing your children to this type of history. It's very important that this history be shared with the upcoming generation so they know and understand how we got from there here. And often this history is not illuminated in our public sphere, and this film does an incredible job of just giving you a full history of, you know, the development of this country and where we are today with regard to race relations. I'd like to say thank you to Lisa, to Vanetta, to Karen, to Noah, and to my friend of over 30 years, Marsha Thurman, who was crucial and is part of the committee. She was present. I grew up in a household and Marsha was there where there was so much going on all the time in terms of dialogue about race, about the state of affairs in America, about the struggle of the country to kind of find an identity, a true identity, not the identity that was being promoted, you know, through the media and through Hollywood, but what was really going on underneath, you know, behind the scenes. And, you know, sat in as a child on some of the most incredible debates and arguments and dialogues between my uncle and other famous writers and musicians and artists and activists. And it really meant that my political consciousness was formulated very young. And that I had a different sense of the world than most of my peers, you know, growing up. And it made it difficult because it was hard for me to sort of digest things that I knew were not true. So I was combative. I gave my teachers a hard time. I said, well, that's not the whole story. What about this and what about that? So it kind of, you know, put me in a very difficult position as a child because I was exposed to all of this you see in the film. I grew up with my uncle having this type of dialogue in our home, and you know, and so it had a great impact on me and one for the better. So I encourage the parents here, you know, to introduce their kids to Baldwin. He has the children's book coming out, but there are other books like The Fire Next Time and Go Tell It on the Mountain if you want to introduce your young kids to his writing, because he's such an incredible example of what happens when you decide to claim your own identity, you know. And that's the legacy he left for me, is that I am not afraid to claim my own identity and to formulate that identity according to how I view myself, not how the world views me. So that's the legacy, and it's very important for young people to be exposed to that because it's life-changing.
And this collection that was put together in conjunction with the motion picture that you just saw is also worth getting hold of, and this will go straight to the library here at Brooklyn Friends. I was wondering, Ziba and Michelle, and then I promise you, Ziba and Michelle, if you could just say a few words about the formal achievements of this film. So Ziba is a critic, Michelle is a programmer, if you could just talk a little bit about what all has been accomplished with this film of 2016, and what it, you know, just in terms of what it means to you as a critic, as a programmer, as a human being.
Ooh,
sorry,
too much. In a few words,
no, too much. Sorry.
I mean, I think for me, what was so striking the first time I saw this film, and can you hear me? By
yes.
The way, I don't. Right. The first time I saw this film and seeing it now, it's just that, you know, this is purely Baldwin's words, you know, like this is not a documentary in which we have talking heads coming in and telling you what he was like or telling you, you know, what these words meant. It's his language, mm-hmm. his thoughts, his point of view of the world. And for me, I think that is like, you know, it's the most potent way to get at the ideas that are being presented here by just having his words speak for themselves.